Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be talking about installing the newly leaked Windows 11 dev build on a non-UEFI system. If you're watching this, you're probably already aware that the Windows Setup program will not let you continue if you haven't booted using a UEFI system, as you can see on the screen. It claims that your computer doesn't meet the system requirements. Fortunately, this could not be more wrong, at least at the time of the recording of this video. We'll be using a Dell XPS 410 system, which is equipped with an Intel Core 2 Duo 6300, 4 GB of DDR2 memory, and a blazingly fast 80 GB 7200 RPM Western Digital hard drive. We'll also be using an NVIDIA GeForce GT 1030 for our graphics card, simply for the screen capture, since the original ATI graphics card would not display properly on the capture card. This machine originally came with Windows Vista Home Premium back in 2007, when UEFI was unheard of and certainly not an option on this motherboard. With that being said, let's dig right in. Now to start this off, you'll need to have the Windows 11 Dev Build ISO, as well as a copy of Rufus, which is free to download, to make a bootable USB flash drive. If you're looking for a link to the Windows 11 Dev Build, you'll find it if you search hard enough, but you won't find it here. When you're in Rufus, make sure you select a standard master boot record Windows installation. If you're unsure what you're doing, there's plenty of how-tos on Rufus on YouTube, but I won't demonstrate here. Once that's done, it should boot as we see on the screen. You'll notice that I'm not speeding up the video, as I want you to suffer through the long installation process with me. I'm not the devil, however. You'll find the time shortcuts in the description of the video. If you've made it to this point, congratulations! Your computer does meet the requirements to run the Windows 11 dev build. If you crashed along the way with a blue screen of death or some other message, well, it might be time to upgrade for real. Anyway, I'll demonstrate that this computer also gets the incompatibility issue. So as you can see, we have the infamous message that tells us our computer's too old and we can't continue. There's no way to move forward, you can only go backwards or go nowhere at all. Thankfully, there is a workaround, but do keep in mind that this workaround only installs the home edition of Windows 11. We'll start by pressing Shift and F10 at the same time, which will bring up a command prompt window. Once we're in, start the diskpart application, that's one word, and once that's started, type in list disk to show a list of physical drives that are connected to the system. Select the one you want, as in my case, I'll type select disk 0. Then we'll do the clean command. This will wipe all the data on the disk, so please do a backup if you have anything important you want to keep. After it's cleaned, we'll type in create partition primary, followed by the format fs equals ntfs quick command. This will make one large partition for us to install Windows on. After the format is complete, type active to make the partition bootable, and you'll see the video cut here for a second. Don't forget to mount the partition we just created. I'm going to post the next commands up on the screen. Make sure you spell these properly, otherwise you're going to scratch your head for a second like I did here when I mistyped the DISM command and wondered what the error code meant. Now, depending on the type of flash drive you use, the kind of storage you're installing to, or the speed of your computer, this could take a while. This process is the same that the Windows setup uses, we're just doing it manually through the command line. Once that's done and it's been completed successfully, we'll do one last command, bcdboot space c colon backslash windows space forward slash s space c colon backslash, and then we are all set to reboot the machine. Once it's rebooted, you can feel free to remove the flash drive just in case you don't boot to it again. And if you've made it this far, congratulations, you've installed Windows 11. Now follow through the setup like normal, be forced to sign into your Microsoft account per usual, and do whatever setup steps you like. This is now your machine, your personalization. Interestingly, you'll see in a few minutes here a feature I haven't heard of yet, where Microsoft will let you move your files from one drive onto a new computer, will show up during the out-of-box experience. And voila, we've made it to the Windows desktop, even though the setup and the rumors claimed we'd never make it to this point. You can watch me fool around with Windows here for a minute, but as far as this tutorial is concerned, you did it! You'll see I find a bug right away, too, when Windows installs my display drivers. As the DPI suddenly changes, the taskbar goes transparent. Very interesting. Thank you for watching this, and I hope it helped you in some way. Leave a like and subscribe if you'd like and comment your experience. I'd love to see the system specs you use to install this using this tutorial.